A model is a concept of how the brain works. I think it's worth noting that we're really far off from this kind of overall situation where we have a working model of the entire brain and we can actually target and go after specific diseases, but it is the envision all of us would like to see. Nathan and I, in our particular fields, we characterize how neurons fire so that you know how they're communicating. We make these models to confirm that our ideas about how the brain works are indeed correct.
Yeah, I mean, it's a concept with some math. You want to know that when you make kind of specific changes in something, you can have a prediction of how that neuron will fire or what decision will this circuit make. And a model could be a couple of equations, and then it's easy just to make a graph and kind of, you know, have a prediction of see if your data lines up with that graph. A model could be a computer program, but at the heart of it, it is, you know, trying to represent these core concepts with some sort of mathematical framework. An important thing to keep in mind is that a model doesn't have to be exactly right to be useful. We can still learn something from it, even if it doesn't get all the details exactly right.
I think all researchers and scientists really want to know how things work. And you can imagine it as the time that you invest into your child, for example, and you see that kid give up and do their first fifth grade play, and you're like, all of this energy and time and emotional investment culminates in this thing. And it's a nice feeling.
It's easy to sort of tell ourselves stories about how the brain might be working. And models are sort of forcing you to say, like, well, if I think this story is really right, can I express it with numbers and then see how well it actually performs? It's a way of testing our ideas, which will help lead us to better experiments in the future.